Good morning, one and all. So today we are going to discuss about microwave T-junctions. So in your transmission line, sometimes it is necessary to combine the two or more microwave signals into one signal or split a single signal into a two or more components. So at that situation, the most commonly used waveguide component is nothing but a waveguide T-junctions. The main important T-junctions are E-plane T-junction, H-plane T-junction and hybrid T-junction. So here all these characteristics, construction and behavior parameters are analyzed by using the scattering parameters or S parameters. So this scattering parameters gives the input and output power relationships at each and every port in a waveguide junction. E-plane T-junction. So here this E-plane T-junction is constructed by interconnecting of three rectangular waveguide section. So for this construction, initially we have to construct the one rectangular waveguide. So for this rectangular waveguide, the two open ports are considered to be port 1 and port 2. And for this main waveguide section, so we are making the cut along the wider dimension and attaching the auxiliary port or side arm, that is considered as port 3. So why it is considered as E-plane T-junction means, if you are observing the diagram, it is in the shape of alphabet T. And here the axis of the side arm is parallel to the electric field of the main waveguide. So that means this E-plane T-junction purely divides the electric field in between the port 1 and port 2 equally with 180 degrees phase shift. So here this diagram, two-way transmission of the E-plane T-junction, gives the direction of the electric field lines. So here the input is applied at port 1 and port 2 with 180 degrees phase shift. That means here the opposite lines is indicating the phase difference. So then the addition of the power, the adding of the power or adding of the signal is observed at port 3. So now in the second case, in the B, so if the input is applied at port 3, then it divides in between the port 1 and port 2 with out of phase, that means 180 degrees phase shift. Now in order to analyze these characteristics, we have to derive the S parameters or scattering parameters or S matrix. So here it is having the total 3 ports, so therefore the order of the S matrix is 3 by 3. So that means here it is having the 3 rows and 3 columns. So here the coefficients are S11, S12, S13, S21, S22, S23, S31, S32 and S33. So here it is considered that if all the 3 ports are perfectly matched to the junction, then there is no reflections from the each and every port. So then the diagonal coefficients are said to be 0. And here the incident power at port 3 is divided in between 1 and 2 with 180 degrees phase shift equally. So that means the reflection coefficient S13 is same as the S23 with phase shift. So here the negative sign is indicating that there is an opposite phase in between the 1 and 2. So that's why here the coefficients S13 is equals to minus S23. So here the E-plane T-junction, the operation is explained by this diagram for different in-phase and out-of-phase signals. In the first case, for this E-plane, the main waveguide ports A and C and auxiliary port or the E-arm is considered to be B. Then, so if the power is incident at auxiliary port B in this direction, so then it coming out of the port A and port 3, port C with the opposite phase. So here because of this plane of geometry, so there is a change in direction while it is dividing in between the port A and port 3. So in the second case, so here the signal is in phase signal. Both the signals at the port A and C are having the same amplitude with the same phase. So because of this plane of geometry, so the opposite directed signals are coming from the port B. So that's why the cancellation of the power takes place, and finally no signal is coming from this port. In the next case, so if you are observing this diagram, so here both the signals at port 3 and port 4 are equal amplitude with out of phase. So both are added because of this plane of geometry, and some of the power is coming from port B. And here in case of next diagram, so the input is applied at only port A. Then some power will be coming from port B and some power will be coming from port C. So here it is representing some out of phase signal. Similarly, in the next case, if the power is incident at port C, so again it divides in between the port B and port A with in phase signals. Okay, so here this diagram is representing the direction of the electric field lines, so from one port to the another port. Now, so in order to derive the complete S matrix of a three port E plane T junction, so we have to apply the four properties of a S matrix. One is the square matrix, already earlier we are discussed, and another one is the symmetric property. If the network is lossless, and if the network is a reciprocal network, so then Sij is equals to Sji. So that means S equals to S transpose. So S must be a symmetric matrix. So then the coefficients, so S12 is equals to S21 and S13 is equals to S31 and S23 is equals to S32. And here it is considered that the main waveguide ports is divided the power. So S13 is equals to S23. Or S13 is equals to minus S23. So because of this 180 degrees phase shift. So that's why, so if you are considering the S, this is the S matrix after applying the symmetric property and dividing property. So after that, here whatever the port is attached to the main waveguide section, that is the E port, which is said to be perfectly matched to the junction. So that means there is no reflections from this port. So then S33 coefficient must be equals to 0. So now out of 9 reflection coefficients after applying the symmetric property and a perfectly matched condition, now it is reduced to 4 unknowns, S11, S12, S13. Okay, so now in order to analyze, in order to find out this reflection coefficient, we have to apply the remaining two properties. It is nothing but a zero property and unitary property. So then we can find out the individual reflection coefficients S11, S12, S12, S13 and etc. So where we are getting the S13 is equals to 1 by root 2 and S12 and S11 is equals to 1 by 2. So where here it is S13 is equals to minus S23. So that's why here we are getting the minus of minus 1 by root 2 and here it is the minus 1 by root 2. So now H plane T junction. So again it is in the alphabet of T shape. So here, auxiliary port is attached in a x direction. So now in this case, again we are considering the main rectangular waveguide section and we are attaching the one auxiliary port by making the cut along the narrow dimension. This is the narrow dimension. So we are making the cut along the narrow dimension and attaching the one side arm or auxiliary arm. So that axis of the side arm is parallel to the magnetic field in a main waveguide section. So that means here it divides the magnetic field in between the 1 and 2 with in phase. So that's why, so this T junction is called it as H plane T junction. Another name of H plane T junction is nothing but a current T junction. And here, So in phase signals are coming from observing at port 1 and port 2. So if you are observing the S matrix is similar to the E plane T junction, but only the difference is, so here the phase shift. So here the port is divided in between the 1 and 2 with in phase signal. That means S13, so S13 is same as S23. That is the main difference in between the E plane and H plane T junction. Again, here it is access both power divided as well as power splitter. So magic T junction, another name of magic T is nothing but a hybrid T junction. So this hybrid T junction is constructed by the combination of both the E plane as well as H plane T junction. That means again initially we are considering the main waveguide section. So those ports are port 1 and port 2. So for this collinear arms we are making the cut along the wider dimension and narrow dimension, and we are attaching the auxiliary port, port 3 E arm, port 4 H arm. Then here it is a 4 port hybrid T junction. So hybrid is a combination of both E and H. So this magic T is having the advantages or several characteristics when comparing with your E and H plane. So what are the characteristics of this magic T junction means? So here the two waves of equal magnitude and the same phase are fed into the port 1 and port 2. Then there is no power will be coming from port 3. Because of this plane of geometry, here it is executing the 180 degree phase shift. The cancellation of the power is observed. So that's why no power will be coming from port 3 and addition of the power will be coming from port 4. So similarly, if the power is incident at port 3, it divides in between the 1 and 2 and no power will be coming from port 4. So here the port 3 and port 4 are said to be isolated ports. There is a proper separation in between these two ports. So similarly, the port 1 and port 2 are said to be isolated port. The incident power at the port 1 or port 2 is divided in between the adjacent ports 3 and 4, and no power will be coming from port 2 and port 1. So that means here the S43, S34 is equals to 0 and S12 and S21 is equals to 0. So that's way. So all these four combinations, that means all the four ports are perfectly matched condition S11, S22, S33, S44. Diagonal matrix coefficients are 0. And so the isolated ports 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, S12, S21, S34 and S43 are equals to 0. This is the S matrix of a magic T junction. And in order to find out the remaining coefficients, again we have to apply the remaining properties. It is nothing but a unitary property and zero property. After by simplifying the S matrix, we can, after simplifying the, all those equations, then we can find out the coefficients of S13, S14 and S32 and so on and etc. So here what are the main characteristics of the magic T means all the four ports are perfectly matched to the junction and divides into equally in between the adjacent ports. If the signal is fed at any one of the coplanar arms, it is the main waveguide port 1 and 2 or 3 and 4 is split equally in between the E and H arms. So at each output port, the output power will be the half of the input power. That means there is an equality. So that's why it is called as 3 dB split up. So here what the difference is, if the power is coming from, if the power is incident at E arm, it divides in between 1 and 2 with 180 degrees out of phase. If the power is incident at H arm, it divides in between the 1 and 2 with in phase. That is the main difference. That means here it is having the characteristics of both E as well as H. Coming to hybrid ring. So another name of hybrid ring T junction is nothing but a rat race T junction. So here the construction is different from the magic T junction, but operation and characteristics are similar. So here if you are observing this diagram of the hybrid ring, so this junction is constructed in the form of angular ring shape, where the four ports are arranged in a such a way that the two ports are separated with a path length of 3 lambda g by 4 distance, and remaining two, three ports are separated with a difference of lambda g by 4, lambda g by 4, lambda g by 4. The total circumference here it is representing the 6 lambda g by 4. So based on this construction, so here it is executing the similar characteristics of the magic T junction. So if that is, if the power is incident at a port 1, it divides equally in between the adjacent ports, port 2 and port 4, and no power will be coming from port 3. So here it is execute that characteristics based on the path difference. So the incident power or signal at port 1 directed in two ways. One is clockwise direction and another one is the anti-clockwise direction. So based on this directionality and a path difference, so here it is providing the in-phase signals and out-of-phase signals. So the in-phase signals are added at each and every port and out-of-phase signals are cancelled at the port. So that's why the separation of the signal is observed at the opposite port and in-phase signals are observed at the adjacent ports. So here the S matrix of a hybrid ring T junction is explained here. Again, all the four ports are perfectly matched to the junction, so that's why the diagonal matrix are 0. And here the power is incident at port 1 is divided in between the adjacent ports. So that's why so the S there is a coefficient of S12 and S21. So similarly, so the adjacent coefficients, the opposite coefficients are exist. Again, in order to find out each and every coefficient, again we have to explain the S properties of a S matrix. So the practical view of the waveguide T junctions. So here is the E plane T junction, H plane T junction, magic T junction. It's a combination of both E and H. So this one is representing the rat race T junction. So here it is representing the difference. So angular ring shape, these are the four ports. This is a separation of 3 lambda g by 4, lambda g by 4, lambda g by 4 and lambda g by 4. So thank you.